వందే శంభుమాపతిం సురగురుం వందే జగత్కారణం వందే పన్నగభూషణం శశిధరం వందే పశూనాం పతిం వందే సూర్యశశాంకవన్నినయనం వందే ముకుందప్రియం వందే భక్తజన ఆశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే భక్తజన ఆశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే శివం శంకరం. ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెరీ సూన్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సెలబ్రేట్ గీతా జయంతి, ద డే వెన్ గీతా ఈజ్ మేడ్ అవైలబుల్ టు ద పబ్లిక్. దెర్ ఆర్ టూ డేస్, ద డే వెన్ శ్రీ కృష్ణ సాంగ్ ది సాంగ్ సెలెస్టియల్ అండ్ ద డే ది గీతా ఈజ్ మేడ్ అవైలబుల్ టు ద పబ్లిక్. This is the day on which Bhagavad Gita is made available to the society, to the posterity. Bhagavad Gita is a song sung by the Almighty. Bhagavan himself has sung that beautiful song. What is the purpose? What does it contain? In what way it is relevant to the present day age? In what way it is useful to us? What is the pragmatic value? Is it only a dialogue between two people? Is it a philosophical discourse? Is it a way to escape from the problems of the society? Does it give the strength to face the problems? These are the various questions that arise when we think of Bhagavad Gita. First and foremost, Bhagavad Gita is a panacea to all the evils of life. Panacea means medicine. Sarva roga nivarini. All the ailments troubling the mankind can be eradicated. All the problems troubling the human mind will be erased, and we can lead a peaceful life. The first and foremost purpose of studying Gita is to get the peace of mind. Since it gives us peace of mind, it is Yoga Shastra. Yoga is a journey from restlessness to restfulness. We are every day agitated, disturbed. We are unable to be poised. We are unable to be calm. We are unable to be tranquil. We are unable to be serene and composed. Therefore, we require some support, some method by which we can continue to be peaceful. We need not be troubled anymore. That is the purpose of the Bhagavad Gita, and that is the purpose of yoga. Therefore, at the end of each chapter, you find ఇతి శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీతాసు ఉపనిషత్సు బ్రహ్మ విద్యాయాం యోగ శాస్త్రే శ్రీకృష్ణ అర్జున సంవాదే. యోగ శాస్త్ర, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ స్క్రిప్చర్ ఆఫ్ యోగా, ఇట్ ఈస్ బికాస్ ఇట్ గివ్స్ అస్ పీస్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్. బ్రహ్మ విద్య ఈజ్ స్పిరిచువల్ సైన్స్, స్పిరిచువల్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద మెటీరియలిస్టిక్ బాదరేషన్స్, ఫ్రమ్ ద వరల్డ్లీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. We get removed, we get elevated to a higher level, and that higher abstract subtle level is called spirituality. That which is all pervading, that which gives you permanent happiness, that which leaves you in the ocean of bliss is called spiritual science, and in Sanskrit it is Brahma Vidya. Upanishads contain this Brahma Vidya. The essence of the Upanishads is brought into Bhagavad Gita. We are supposed to have about 108 Upanishads. Of the 108 Upanishads, 10 have been culled out, selected, and these 10 Upanishads have been made popular by the Ramakrishna Math and many, many Swamijis. What do the Upanishads contain? They contain the spiritual lore of this country. They contain the spiritual bliss. The essence of the Upanishads is taken. We may not be in a position to read all the Upanishads. Even if we read all the Upanishads, we may not be in a position to understand the Upanishads. Therefore, we require a teacher. We require an editor. We require an interpreter. We require a master or guru to give the essence of the Upanishads. And that master, that teacher, that acharya is Sri Krishna. Therefore, beautifully in a stanza it is put, Sarvopanishado Gavo Dogtha Gopalanandanaha Partho Vatsa Sudhir Bhoktaha Dugdham Gitamritam Mahat. The entire Upanishadic lore is like a cow. The cow herd is Sri Krishna. He milks that cow. He collects that milk and gives it to the vatsa, to the calf, to the seeker, to the sadhaka, to the man, that is Arjuna. So the cows make the Upanishadic lore, or the vice versa. The milk is brought out and given to the person in need. We are all the people in need. So Arjuna is only an instrument. To Arjuna, Krishna has given the Upanishad Sara, the milk of the Upanishads. Therefore, at the end of the stanza, you find Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gita Su Upanishatsu. The content of the Upanishad is culled out. The milk of the Upanishads is brought out, Upanishatsu. And what does it contain? Brahma Shastra, Brahma Vidya. And that Brahma Vidya is meant to give us not only peace of mind, but blissful state. And therefore, it is Yoga Shastra. Three words, three phrases have been used, Upanishatsara, Brahma Vidya, and Yoga Shastra. Bhagavad Gita is spiritual science, point number one. Bhagavad Gita is the essence of the Upanishads, point number two. And Bhagavad Gita is the Yoga Shastra, point number three. All the three are needed. What for? Number one, to face the problem. We have, right from birth till death, problem after problem after problem after problem. To sit in the classroom for 60 minutes is a very big problem. You prepare the love letter and you have to give it to the girl, it is at another big problem. To face the examination is a problem. Some people find it difficult to face the husbands when they come from the offices. Some husbands find it very difficult to face the volcanic faces of the wives. Problems. Everywhere you have a problem. The child has its own problem. The old man has his own problem. I have not yet come across a gentleman or a lady who can boldly say, I am free from problems, sir, I don't have any problem. Impossible. If anybody is there like that without problems, either he must be a sleeping person or a dead person. A living person does have the problems. Arjun has the problem. The problem of Arjuna is to face the battle. The problem of the people is to face the boss, to face the husband, to face the wife, to face the examination, to face the interview, to face many, many things. First is, we are unable to face the problem. If you read Bhagavad Gita, we will be in a position to face the problem. Whether you solve it or not, that is secondary. We need not run away from the problem. Arjun has arrived on the battlefield with enthusiasm, with all vigor, with all vitality, with all knowledge, with all strength, with all skill, to wage a war and to conquer, to be the victorious person. Similarly, in our life incidents, the boy has prepared for the examination very, very well. He has memorized the required topics. He goes to the examination hall. Suddenly, a strange fear creeps into his mind. He gets confused. He may not remember the subject. He may get the reeling sensation. He may be sweating profusely, and mind may become totally vacant. And he would say, I do not want to face the examination. I want to go back. Similarly, when you go to the interview hall, looking at the people sitting in front of you like the nine planets, in the middle, Shani, this side four, this side four, nine people are seated in the interview board. The boy goes to the interviewing hall. Suddenly he loses the sobriety. He loses that alertness, and he gets confused. He knows the answers. He is unable to give the answers. It's a strange situation. A young bridegroom comes to see the girl. The girl is very well trained in Carnatic music. The would-be father-in-law or mother-in-law would make a request, my child sing a song. The moment the child begins to sing, there will be a donkey's braying, and the throat is improper. The song is unable to come out of the throat. She spoils the show. Similarly, you are all seated here. Suddenly I pick out somebody, ask you to come to the stage and deliver the vote of thanks. There will be sweating, shivering, and we fail to deliver the goods. Not that we are less skilled. We do have the knowledge. We do have the determination. We do have the skills, but something strange enters into our mind-body equipment, intellect equipment, and we lose that alertness. Arjuna is like that. Arjuna is such a great man. Arjuna Phalguna Partha Kiriti Bhibhatsa Dhananjaya Savyasachi. He has mastered the art of Vilividya. He has been able to win the Pashupatastra from Lord Shiva himself. He has earned the advanced archery skills in Indraloka. So many titles have been given to him, and he is known for his strength confidence, determination, enthusiasm, vitality, vigor, everything. 11 Akshonis on the opposite side. This side he has a 7 Akshonis. And Lord Krishna himself is there as Parthasarathi, as the charioteer. God himself is with him. He has already offered his protection. We have every equipment. Akshaya Tuniram you have. That particular box containing the shafts which will never be exhausted. Akshaya. Limitlessly, infinitely the arrows will be filled again and again. He is very well equipped. And he has sufficient anger towards the enemies. The moment he looks at Dushyasana, he wants to kill him. The moment he looks at Karna, he wants to tear his tongue for having spoken ill of Draupadi. Such is the equipment of Arjun, but he is unable to face the problem. Don't we experience several such incidents? Very often, we do have it. If it is an international gathering, it is going to decide your Nobel Prize, we become nervous. It is a final examination, the girl has to choose, we become nervous. Karna, for example, is about to shoot that fish. He became nervous. Draupadi shouted, I shall not marry a Sutaputra. A skillful Karna has lost the aim and he has failed. Every person is likely to lose that concentration, likely to lose the confidence, likely to lose the strength, likely to forget the knowledge, likely to forget the skill. And Arjuna is in that plight. Arjuna is in that state. All of us. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is relevant today to make us face the problem. We must be in a position to face the problems. Previous day, Dasharatha Maharaj sent a message to Ram. Mr. Ram, Monday morning, 10 o'clock, you will be the crown prince. Get ready. Sri Ram just smiled and received the news. He did not get elated. He did not lose his composure. He is calm when there is an offer of kingdom, crown, throne. Within 24 hours, the order is reversed. Ram, you cannot be the king. There is no Yuvaraja Pattabhisheka, it is cancelled. Instead of becoming the king of Ayodhya, you have to accept exile. For full 14 years, you are to go to the forest within 24 hours. The pendulum from success to failure, from happiness to depression. The previous day he was asked to be ready for accepting the crown. Within 24 hours the order was withdrawn and Rama was asked to accept the exile. Forest life, life in the woods. Imagine ourselves in the position of Sri Ram. Don't we get disturbed? The first day, the most beautiful girl has written the love letter, I love you. Second day, the same girl says, by mistake I have written your address. The letter is not meant to you, but it is meant to your roommate. Where do we go? Should I commit suicide? The Prime Minister of India sent me a message that I would be the governor of Telangana. Within 24 hours, the message is reversed. Sorry, sir. Opposition parties are not acceptable to your appointment. Kaikeyi does not like it. Mandara does not like it. Ram, therefore, you should go to the forest. Don't we experience these ups and downs in life? Should we get elated? Should we fall depressed? Equanimity. Unless we have that poised state of mind, balanced state of mind, equanimity, unless we cultivate, we cannot face the problems of life. Bhagavad Gita is the only book which is the essence of the Upanishads to highlight that equanimity, and that equanimity is Yoga Shastra. Whether it is spiritual science or Yoga Shastra, whether it is worldly wisdom or spiritual scholarship, everywhere the basic requirement is calmness. Therefore, when the problems accost us, we will be in a position to face them under any circumstances. We will not lose our poise. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is relevant to us. Next is solve the problem. While solving the problem, if you have attachment to the fruit, you may not be in a position to concentrate. Your duty is only to fight. Fight it out. Your duty is only to take the examination. The result is not in your hand. It is in the university's hands. So the second step is impartially, without attachment, without any expectation of the fruit. If you fight, God's there. Anything may happen. And whatever fruit comes, you accept it. This is the second step. That's what Krishna tells Arjun. It's duty. It's your duty to fight and fight it out. Jaya pajaya, they are not in our hands. Hatova prapyasi swargam. If you are killed on the battlefield, you go to swarga. If you fail, you enjoy the entry into swarga. That is, when you are killed or where you lose the battle. If you win the battle, very good, you will be the king. In either way, it is to your benefit. When you perform a duty, be ready for any result. Normally, it is the positive outlook. How is the positive outlook from the worldly point of view? A young boy has gone to the examination hall, IAS. If he passes the examination, he becomes a district collector or a secretary. If he fails, much better, he can become a minister. Both sides, it is beneficial. So there are three steps. Bhagavad Gita is relevant today. One, to face the problems. Two, to solve the problem without expecting any result. Duty as a duty, you do it. And whatever result comes, it is to your advantage. See the benefit in either of the results, good or bad, right or wrong, favorable or unfavorable. All the obstacles are to your advantage, opportunity. So Bhagavad Gita is a book of prudence, worldly wisdom. It is a book of spiritual knowledge. You will be peaceful. It's a book of Yoga Shastra. If people say, what is the relevance of yoga to the present age? What is the relevance of Bhagavad Gita? Don't you want to be peaceful? Don't you want to have sound sleep? Don't you want to be calm under all circumstances? And that is ensured by the study of Bhagavad Gita. Now we can go to the text. Arjun has arrived on the battlefield and he has become nervous. He is in a doubt. He has developed a dilemma and he might have lost his confidence. He says, I shall not fight. Then Krishna's role starts. In the first chapter, Krishna did not speak. The first chapter, Arjuna alone spoke. And at the end of the chapter, we find Arjuna's conclusion, resolution, Nakanche Vijayam Krishna, Nacha Rajyam Sukhanicha. I am not interested in victory. Nakanche Vijayam. Vijaya is victory. Kanksha means desire. I am not interested. I don't want anything. Nacha Rajyam Sukhanicha. I don't want the kingdom. I don't want that happiness. I want to withdraw. Why? When so many people are dead, there will be orphans, there will be widows. Does not Arjuna know that there will be widows before commencing the war? He came, and after having come to the battlefield only, does he have the wisdom that there will be many widows and orphans? When you are preparing for the examination itself, you know that the consequences will be disastrous. When you are about to wage the war, now suddenly why is it? It is coming. It is misplaced mercy. Mercy is good. Compassion is good. Kindness is good. Consideration, concern, they are all good. But misplaced is very bad. Example, one student does not come to the class. He is always late. He always disturbs the other students. Very often, he doesn't come to the campus at all. He goes to the canteen, disturbs the people there. He behaves like a rowdy. He behaves like a gunda. He teases the girls, he spoils the atmosphere, and the final examination has come. The controller of examination says, since you do not have sufficient attendance, we will not give you the hall ticket. The case comes to the principal or vice chancellor. The vice chancellor looks at the boy, poor boy. If he is not given the hall ticket, he will lose 1 year. If he is not given the hall ticket, his mother will weep, his father will weep. Does not the institution go to dogs? 364 days you were angry with him. Last day, when you have to set him right, you suddenly become compassionate, kind, and considerate. It is called misplaced mercy. He does not deserve your consideration. What is the problem created by Duryodhana? Is it a small thing? Problems caused by Dushyasana? The fellow has gone to the women's apartments, has held Draupadi by the hair, he has dragged her literally into the public court hall of Hastinapur, and he has literally tried to disrobe her, such a rogue of the highest order. Should he be considered for mercy? Karna used the very foul words looking at Draupadi. Duryodhana showed his thigh, come and sit on my lap. Does Duryodhana deserve mercy? Does Dushyasana deserve mercy? Does Karna deserve mercy? Does Shakuni deserve mercy? Now suddenly Arjun becomes merciful. This is misplaced mercy, spoiling the institution, endangering the organization, ruining the nation. Terrorism cannot be swallowed. These four are terrorists. And they do not deserve to be shown any consideration. Therefore, Krishna gets angry with Arjun. Mr. Arjun, you came with all enthusiasm to establish dharma. You have come to punish the wicked. You have a duty as kshatriya to perform dharma. Having come, how is it you turn pale? You become diffident? Are you a coward? And the first thing that Sri Krishna tells in the second chapter is, Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam anaryajustam asvargyam akirtikaram arjuna trudram hridayadaurbalyam tyaktvottishtaparantapa. Is this the time to be cowardly? Is this the time to express your consideration? Is this the time to run away from the battlefield? Kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam. It is not in tune with a cultured person. It is inappropriate for a kshatriya to establish dharma. This is not the way. You should have told me earlier. We would not have convened the great battle at all. We would not have come to the battlefield at all. Having come, is this the way? Kshudram, very mean, very dirty. Hridaya daurbalyam, that is the word. Hridaya is heart. Daurbalya is weakness. It is a psychic weakness to run away from the responsibilities. It is a psychic weakness to be away from the problems, unable to face. If you read Vivekananda's works, only one thing we will get again and again. All problems are because of our weakness. Strength at the physical level, strength at the psychic level, strength at the intellectual level, strength at the spiritual level. Strength, strength, strength alone can solve all the problems. When we become weak, everything is burdensome. Everything is terrible. Face the brute. Swami Vivekananda was walking in Benares. A few monkeys started chasing him. He was then a wandering monk with a stick in his hand, with a shaven head and the saffron robes. The monkeys were very large in size. They were running, chasing him. He tried to run away from the monkeys. We may experience that while driving a two-wheeler. Dogs will be coming along with us. If you try to run away, the more you run, the more the dogs chase you. Similarly, the more you run away from the problems, the more the problems catch you. The more you are afraid of the husband, the more the husband will be shouting. The more you are afraid of the wife, the more she will be troubling. The more you are afraid of the boss, the more he will enslave you. The best way is to face, hey, what are you doing? Roar like a lion, the boss will become a lamb. Roar like a lion, the wife will become a mouse. Roar like a lion, the husband will be a wagging dog's tail. The one requirement to face the problems is strength, 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 Vivekananda says. Sri Krishna at the very outset says, Trudram hridaya daurbalyam. It is psychic weakness, man. Is it not relevant to our age? All our problems are because academically we are weak. We are afraid of examinations. Physically we are weak, afraid of the ailments. Morally we are weak, afraid of the police and the wives and the husbands. Ethically we are weak, and therefore we are unable to face the society. At every level, strength. Academically, we have to be strong. Morally, we have to be strong. Ethically, we have to be strong. Physically, we have to be strong. And emotionally, we have to be strong. And spiritually, we have to be strong. The message of Bhagavad Gita, therefore, is strength, strength, strength. And the same thing has been given by Swami Vivekananda in his wonderful lectures. The message of Swamiji is strength, 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 and that answer he got from Bhagavad Gita. Is it all new? Certainly not. Determination is with us, inborn in us. Willpower is there with us. It is the essential trait or quality in us. And we do have the curiosity. We do have the knowledge, urge to learn. That's also inbuilt in us. Love, it is there already available in every heart. There is no person without a heart, and there is no heart without love. When you love, whom you love, where you love, how you love, the language of love, the quality of love, the intensity of love, the expression of love may change from person to person. Some people may love the country, some people may love their children, some people may love their partners, some people love their own selves, and some people love life. All of us love life. I love myself. What is it that we do before coming to this Mangal Mandir or Samskriti Bhavan? From the rooms when you start, wash your face, brush your hair, look before the mirror, adjust the hair, tilt the eyebrow, touch the cheeks, wet the lips, throw a smile. Oh, wonderful, my man. Even at the age of 80, you look very grand. I love myself. This is the secret. Next, we love life. When I say life, love life, somebody may say, no, sir, my friend has committed suicide. True. He or she loves death. My point is love. When that love is purified, when that love is ennobled, when that love is divinized, it is called Bhakti Yoga. There is determination in us. There is willpower in us. That willpower sometimes becomes weak. That determination sometimes declines. As and when it declines or becomes weak, we have to strengthen it. For strengthening it, we require Bhagavad Gita. It is there hidden in us. A child is lying on the back. It has the willpower to turn to a side. Having turned to a side, the child has the willpower to sit up. Sits up. And the child has this determination to stand up. It stands up. The child has the determination to walk. It takes steps. Every time it stands up and takes steps, it falls. It doesn't lose the confidence. It does not get its willpower weakened with a tenacity of purpose. Again it stands up, again it struggles, again it walks. That willpower is with us. That determination is with us. That love is present in us. And we are never calm. We always ask questions. Curiosity. Where does this train go? Curiosity. Who is the head of this institution? Curiosity. Is he married? Next question. Has he been an awardee of Padma Shri? Next query. Has he bribed anybody? Curiosity. When one boy and girl are together, are they husband and wife? Are they lovers? Are they brother and sister? Why should you worry? Curiosity to learn, that knowledge, urge to learn is hidden in us. Knowledge is available. Love is available. Determination or willpower is available. And we have the habit of surrendering. The baby surrenders to the mother. baby is at the mercy of the mother. The mother beats the child. Child holds on to the mother and weeps. You observe any child? The child cannot run away. Even if God beats us, gives us problems, we hold on to the feet of the Almighty. To the driver, we submit our life. I do not know who the cab driver is. I engage the cab from here to the airport. I sit in the car. My life is surrendered at his feet. It is in his steering that my life is locked up. He can kill me. Every day I go home to eat food from my wife's hand if she poisons. I trust, I surrender. I surrender myself at the feet of so many people. That quality of self-surrender also is with us. Are we quiet any moment? Nahi kaschik kshanamapi jatu tisthyatya karma kriti. Even for a fraction of a second, we are never quiet. Every moment we are engaged in some activity or other. Pulsation is an activity. Breathing is an activity. Heartbeat is an activity. Blood circulation is an activity. Talking is an activity. Sitting is an activity. Looking is an activity. Listening is an activity. Living is an activity. Dying is also an activity. Every moment we are engaged in action. So four things are with us. Number one, determination or willpower. Number two, we have that intellect giving us knowledge. Number three, we have the heart that feels love. Fourth, we are engaged in action. And finally, we have the art of self-surrender. When do we get this lack of determination? When you lose confidence. Arjun has all the five. He has the determination. He has lost it. He has the knowledge of the enemy. He has forgotten it. He has the knowledge of his own strength. He has failed to remember it. He is always an active person. He wants to run away from the battlefield. He is a man of love. It is misplaced, not properly guided. And he offered himself at the feet of Krishna many times, I surrender. Sishyasteham swadhimam tvam prapannam. Now all the five are mysteriously absent in the heart of Arjun when he has come to accost the problem. Similarly, all the five inherent traits, inherent qualities are suddenly forgotten by us and everything becomes very, very frightening. Krishna, therefore, in the 17 chapters of Bhagavad Gita, revives the willpower. He is not giving the willpower. Already it is there. He invigorates it. He tries to ignite it. It is there already. Similarly, his activities are made duty bound. His knowledge is brought to the surface. His love is purified and his self-surrender is intensified. So what does Bhagavad Gita do? It does not give us anything which we do not have. We have these five qualities. What is hidden in us, it is brought to the surface. The man has money, he has forgotten about it. It is there. We find some people asking, especially my grandmother and grandfather, they say, where did I keep these spectacles? They will be searching for these spectacles. The grandson says, Granny, Granny, you are wearing these spectacles. Sorry. What the old woman has, she has forgotten. Similarly, all the merits are with us. ఆల్ ది వర్చ్యూస్ ఆర్ విత్ అస్, ఆల్ ది స్ట్రెంగ్త్స్ ఆర్ విత్.
భగవద్గీత గివ్స్ వాట్ వీ హ్యావ్. దట్స్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్. అండ్ దెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ వన్, ఆల్ ద రిమైనింగ్ కమ్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ. ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఏ గుడ్ కర్మయోగి, భక్తి కమ్స్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ. ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఏ గుడ్ భక్త, జ్ఞాన కమ్స్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ.
ఇఫ్ యు హ్యావ్ ది డిటర్మినేషన్, ఆల్ ద త్రీ కమ్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ. అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఆల్ ది ఫోర్ ఆర్ ప్రెసెంట్, శరణాగతి కమ్స్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ. వన్ లీడ్స్ టు ది అదర్. ఆల్ ది ఫైవ్ ఆర్ నాట్ వాటర్ టైట్ కంపార్ట్మెంట్స్. దట్స్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్, శ్రీ కృష్ణ హ్యాస్ త్రీ హీరోయిన్స్. వన్ ఈజ్ రుక్మిణి, వి నో హిజ్ వైఫ్. ద సెకండ్ ఈజ్ సత్యభామ, వెరీ ఫాండ్ ఆఫ్, హీ ఈజ్ ఆఫ్ సత్యభామ. త్రీ ఈజ్ రాధ, అవర్ ఫ్రెండ్ రాధ. రాధ, ఇఫ్ యూ గో టు మథుర, రాధేకృష్ణ రాధేకృష్ణ రాధే 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 రాధే. హూ ఇస్ దిస్ రాధ? వీ మే ఈవెన్ ఫర్గెట్ కృష్ణ, బట్ నాట్ రాధ. ఐ థింక్ వ్యాస మహర్షి హ్యాస్ నాట్ బీన్ ఏబుల్ టు డిస్క్రైబ్ రాధ ఇన్ భాగవత బికాస్ హీఈస్ అనేబుల్ టు డిస్క్రైబ్ లవ్. ఏ లవర్ కెన్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్, లవ్ కెనాట్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్. హనీ కెన్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్, స్వీట్నెస్ కెనాట్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్. రసగుల్లా కెన్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్, ది స్మూత్నెస్, ది సాఫ్ట్నెస్, ద స్వీట్నెస్ కెనాట్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్. రాధ ఈజ్ లవ్, కృష్ణ ఈజ్ లవర్. కృష్ణ కెన్ బి డిస్క్రైబ్డ్, లవ్ ఈజ్ విత్ అస్. రాధ ఈజ్ వన్ హీరోయిన్, రుక్మిణి ఈజ్ అనదర్ హీరోయిన్, సత్యభామ ఈజ్ ది థర్డ్ హీరోయిన్. ఈచ్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ యోగ. ఆల్ ది త్రీ హ్యావ్ స్ట్రాంగ్ విల్ పవర్. రుక్మిణి హ్యాస్ ట్రెమెండస్ డిటర్మినేషన్. సత్యభామ, రాధ, దే హ్యావ్ త్రీ పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ ది ఫుల్ విల్ పవర్. ఆల్సో దే హ్యావ్ సరెండర్డ్ ఎట్ ది ఫీట్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ. డిటర్మినేషన్ అండ్ సెల్ఫ్ సరెండర్ ఆర్ అవైలబుల్ విత్ ఆల్ ద త్రీ గర్ల్స్, రుక్మిణి, రాధ అండ్ సత్యభామ. బట్ పాత్స్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్. విల్ టేక్ రుక్మిణి ఫస్ట్. రుక్మిణి డస్ నాట్ నో కృష్ణ ఇనీషియల్లీ. షీ హ్యాస్ నాట్ సీన్ కృష్ణ. నారద మహర్షి కేమ్. హీఈస్ ది పబ్లిక్ రిలేషన్స్ ఆఫీసర్, మ్యాట్రిమోనియల్ బ్రోకర్, సోషల్ మీడియా, ఫేస్బుక్, ఇంటర్నెట్ ఎట్సెట్రా. దిస్ నారద మహర్షి కేమ్ టు ది ప్యాలెస్ ఆఫ్ రుక్మిణి. రుక్మిణి ఇస్ ది డాటర్ ఆఫ్ కింగ్ భీష్మక ఆఫ్ విదర్భ దేశ. రుక్మిణి ఇస్ ఎ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ గర్ల్, వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్. దిస్ నారద మహర్షి కేమ్, లుక్ ఎట్ హర్. టు యూ దేర్ ఈస్ ఎ వర్దీ హస్బెండ్ కాల్డ్ కృష్ణ ఇన్ ద్వారక. క్యూరియాసిటీ, హీ ఈస్ ది సన్ ఆఫ్ నారద, ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్. వాట్ ఈస్ హిజ్ ఏజ్, నారద గేవ్. హౌ డస్ హీ లుక్ లైక్, మోస్ట్ హ్యాండ్సమ్. హీ వెంట ఆన్ డిస్క్రైబింగ్ కృష్ణ. హీ గేవ్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ టు రుక్మిణి. దేర్ ఫర్ షీ బికేమ్ ఎ జ్ఞాని. జ్ఞాని ఈజ్ వన్ హూ నోస్ అబౌట్ ది హస్బెండ్, నోస్ అబౌట్ బ్రహ్మ, నోస్ అబౌట్ నాల్ వరల్డ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. రుక్మిణి హ్యాస్ లెర్న్డ్, షీ హ్యాస్ ఎక్వైర్డ్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ. వెన్ యూ గెట్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ రసగుల్ల, ఐ లవ్ ఇట్. సంబడి హ్యాస్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ రసగుల్ల. వెన్ ద రసగుల్ల ఈస్ బీయింగ్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్, సెలీవా కమ్స్ హియర్. When you love it, you must get it. You prepare. Preparation of rasagulla is karma, kriya. Loving rasagulla is bhakti. Knowing about rasagulla is knowledge. Rukmini is described. Krishna is also described. Rukmini has learnt about Krishna, knowledge about God she got. She determined to marry him, to love him. And automatically everything came. Rukmini loved him. Rukmini married him. Rukmini surrendered her all at the feet of Krishna. So Rukmini is a lady of harmonious, holistic yoga. We shall come to Satyabhama. Satyabhama is the daughter of Satrajit. Satrajit is a worshipper of Lord Surya. Surya is pleased with him and he has given a beautiful diamond, Samantakamani. That Samantakamani gives every day several kilos of gold. That Satrajit was wearing that diamond necklace round his neck. One day Krishna saw, Krishna asked, such a Samantakamani should be with the king, we will be feeding the people, please give it. Satrajit said, no, I won't give. Later on, Satrajit's brother carried that Samantakamani to the forest. He was killed by a lion. Lion was killed by Jambavan. Jambavan took that diamond and put it as a toy for his daughter, Jambavati. Now Satrajit began telling that Krishna asked for the diamond. I did not give. Therefore, he killed my brother and stole it away. Krishna could not bear that scandal. He went to the forest, found out the dead body of Satrajit's brother. From there, he found the footprints of the lion. Lion was killed. From there, he found the footprints of the bear, Jambavan. He went to the cave of Jambavan. There he found the diamond. There was a battle. He got the diamond. He got also the beautiful girl, Jambavati. He returned and handed over that diamond to Satrajit. Hey, take back. Satrajit felt sorry. Sorry, sir, Krishna, sir. I have committed the mistake, sir. Please accept my daughter also. Satyabhama does not know Krishna. Satyabhama does not have love or hatred for Krishna. Satyabhama was married. Marriage is karma, kriya, action. So karma was first, kriya was first, marriage was first as far as Satyabhama is concerned. In the case of Rukmini, it is knowledge first. In the case of Satyabhama, it is marriage first. Having married, she served her husband. When she served her husband, she loved her husband. When she loved her husband, she found that her husband is not an ordinary man, he is God. So one after the other, service is followed by love. Love is followed by the knowledge. In the case of Rukmini, knowledge first, others next. In the case of Satyabhama, kriya first, service first, and then everything else. Radha. Radha was a married girl. She was supposed to be about 10 years senior to Krishna. Krishna was in the village. Radha returned from the town, looked at Krishna, a boy of 5 years. He was highly mischievous. His mother Yashoda tied him to a roller. He pulled the roller. He sat in front of his house looking at the girls going to the river and with the water pots and returning from the river. When the girls were going, he was looking at them. When the girls were returning, he was looking at them. Now and then he was whistling and throwing stones, mischievous, teasing. This girl was returning from the river, Radha. Boy was 5 years, Radha was 15 years. She looked at him. She did not know who the fellow is. Krishna looked at her. She looked at him. Whoever loved, that loved not at first sight, at the very first sight, springs up the blush of love. She came, brought down the pot, looked at Krishna. Who are you, my boy? Krishna, what's your name? Radha. I love you. I love you. They loved each other. Rukmini had the knowledge of Krishna. సత్యభామ సర్వ్డ్ కృష్ణ కర్మ, రాధ లవ్డ్ కృష్ణ. షీ డిడ్ నాట్ నో ఎనీథింగ్ అబౌట్ కృష్ణ. షీ డిడ్ నాట్ ఇనీషియల్లీ సర్వ్ కృష్ణ. షీ డిడ్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ మ్యారీ కృష్ణ. ఇట్ ఈస్ మధుర భావన, బట్ లేటర్ ఆన్ షీ సర్వ్డ్. షీ లెర్న్డ్ దట్ కృష్ణ వాజ్ నాట్ ఎన్ ఆర్డినరీ బాయ్, హీ వాజ్ ది ఎంబాడిమెంట్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్, డివినిటీ. See the three characters, all the three have the beginnings in a strange way. One has the beginning in knowledge, jnana. Another has the beginning in service, karma. Another has beginning in love, prema. All the three are determined. All the three have surrendered. This is how in Bhagavad Gita, when you begin to do your duty, you develop the love for duty. You develop dispassion for the results. You do it with determination, and every fruit of action is for a surrendered at the feet of the Almighty. India itself is Yoga Bhumi. Himalayas are strong, symbolizing determination. In those determined, firm Himalayas, three rivers are born. Ganga is symbolic of jnana. Yamuna is symbolic of bhakti. Saraswati is symbolic of karma. On the banks of river Saraswati, many service centers have come up, and the river irrigates the lands without being seen, without publicity. Jnana is Jnana Ganga sitting on the head of Lord Shiva. Ganga is white because she flows on the body of Shiva, which is besmeared with vibhuti. Vibhuti is the final product. Any time, number of times you try to burn it, it continues to be a sacred ash. Ultimately, we all become dust, ash, vibhuti. That knowledge is conveyed by Jnana Ganga. She sits on the head of Lord Shiva, symbolizing Shiva is a Jnani. And Yamuna, on the banks of Yamuna, Sri Krishna has made Rasalila. He has had his Jalakrida, and it is full of devotion, mirth-making merriment, and therefore Yamuna is a river of bhakti. Yamuna is dark in complexion, Ganga is white in complexion, Saraswati is invisible. When you make a charity, don't make it a publicity. Ego pollutes charity, vanity vitiates divinity. Saraswati is a symbolic of karma yoga service. She does not show herself off, she flows under the earth. These three yogas are born in the hills of determination, willpower, and they are flowing, flowing. At Prayaga, they join. Bhakti, karma, jnana, they all are united. Rukmini, Satyabhama, and Radha, they become one. And they all proceed towards the sea, Samudram. Whatever may be the river, the ultimate goal is to merge with the sea. Born in the Himalayas with determination, the river of knowledge, the river of devotion, the river of service, they flow, become one, and finally they lose their identity. They merge with the sea, they surrender themselves in the ocean, they become one with the ocean. Bhagavad Gita says, like the rivers, like Satyabhama, Radha and Rukmini, hey Arjun, be a man of yoga. Tasmat yogi bhava Arjuna, fall at my feet. Finally, in the Charma Sloka, you find Krishna telling, sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam vraja అహం త్వా సర్వ పాపేభ్యో మోక్షయిష్యామి మా శుచః. భగవద్గీత ఈజ్ రిలెవెంట్ టు బ్రింగ్ అస్ పీస్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్. భగవద్గీత ఈజ్ రిలెవెంట్ టు మేక్ అస్ ఫేస్ ది ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. Bhagavad Gita is relevant to us to remind us of our duty. Bhagavad Gita is relevant to us because we should do it with concentration. Concentration will be lost if you think of the fruit. Be dutiful, perform it. Whatever comes, please accept it. Everything is to our advantage. Determination, knowledge, willpower, devotion, action, and finally self-surrender. If only we observe Bhagavad Gita, apply our minds to Bhagavad Gita, we will lead a peaceful life, we will lead a problem-free life, we will lead a blissful life. May we all, by the grace of God Almighty, Lord Krishna, try to imbibe the spirit of Bhagavad Gita to be peaceful always, to be blissful always. Let us be peacefully useful. Let us be usefully peaceful. Peacefully useful and usefully peaceful is the message of Bhagavad Gita. Let us be strong to be useful to others. Hari Om Tat Sat. Thank you very much. We shall meditate for 30 seconds and end. Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrutyorma amrutangamaya. Om shanti shanti shanti. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya. Sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschid dukkhabhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti.